Yo, how's it going, guys? It is your boy XpeK. So for this week's, is it Tuesday yet? I decided to do a Crucible version of it, only because I've never really done this before, and this week it was Iron Banner. So I thought I would do something a little bit different and just show off all the Crucible stuff I did this week and also last week. So this video will have Trials of Osiris, the weekly bounty nightfall type thing from Crucible that Lord Shax always has, and of course Iron Banner. So this week was pretty nice in terms of loot. I do like the new system they did for Iron Banner. It actually worked out very well. I much prefer the system of, you know, Bungie making it rain loot for us with random rolls, and then towards the end of the week when you hit rank 4 or rank 5, the rewards that Lord Shax has for sell have the really good rolls on them but at a lower light value, so that way you could use the loot you got throughout the week to infuse into what Lord Shax is selling with the really good rolls. I much prefer that system than any other system they've ever done for Iron Banner. Let me know what you guys think. The only real gripes and moans I have about Iron Banner is the skill-based matchmaking system and the rank 3 package. The rank 3 package from Iron Banner doesn't really seem necessary. It just doesn't make sense to me. I'm sure, you know, I'm not going to complain with some extra strange coins and motes, but that's about all you're really getting from the rank 3 package. It doesn't really seem that necessary. Now, the rank 5 package is pretty nice. You're essentially guaranteed an item that is at or around your light level, and it could be something good. My rank 5 packages were okay. I wasn't too overly excited. The sniper I got was meh, kind of a meh roll. If it had higher impact, I probably would have kept it, but honestly, my snipers I currently have are just better in terms of impact and rolls already on them. So briefly a second ago, I mentioned that skill-based matchmaking was definitely in Iron Banner, and I could definitely tell. Because, you know, I would go to the tower, half the people in the tower would have Iron Banner emblems on, and I would look at their loadouts, and they would be, you know, they would not be the loadouts that I would be matching when I would queue up an Iron Banner. You know, I would match a lot of people using Doctrine, and, you know, Last Word, Mida, you know, all the top tier weapons, but everyone in the tower does not have these top tier weapons equipped. It just doesn't make sense. You know, there was one night where I was playing by myself or either with one friend, and we would queue up against, you know, teams of sixes, or the same like couple dozen people all night long, and it just really wasn't fun, you know. I understand that they want the game to be competitive, but I feel like it shouldn't be forced down our throats. You know, I really just want to enjoy games with decent connection and just, you know, sort of average people. I understand people want to play competitive matches and not get pub stomped. There's also another group of people who just want to sort of relax, hang back, play PvP with their friends and not take things too serious. Whenever I hop into the PvP arena, it just really seems like it's like we're in some sort of World League match playing for millions of dollars, when all we're really playing for is like an Iron Banner package that's going to give us like a 330 reward anyways. It just, you know, the amount of people who try really hard is understandable, but it's just like every game people are just sweating way too hard. And I'm not trying to like come off as I'm a cocky player, I'm really good, because, you know, I like to play PvP relaxed. You know, occasionally maybe hit a clip or two. I do want to make a Destiny montage, which I've kind of been keeping on the low. But, you know, it's kind of hard to when everyone's using all these crazy weapons that it just makes, you know, having fun in PvP really, really hard, like near impossible. So moving on to Trials of Osiris, I love the changes they made to it. They're not really that big, you know, I kind of just reshadow what I said last, is it Tuesday yet? Basically, I love how you can do the gold bounty every day, and I really like how there's adept armor pieces. They look a little different. I'm close to collecting all of them, I think, on my warlock, and unfortunately on my titan I've gotten the gauntlets 3 weeks in a row now. So once I probably collect all the armor pieces on my warlock, I'm assuming my warlock will probably be the first to get all 5 of them, because it's the class item counts as well now. I will at least tweet out what the full set looks like and possibly make a video on it. The new Trials gear is like the same model, but it has like a snake skin type of texture to it. It has a completely different texture. If you happen to get an adept armor piece, just put on no shader and check it out. It does have like a teal look on it. A lot of people don't really like the teal. I think it's cool. I like how they're sort of, you know, making seasonal changes to Trials gear in terms of looks. But in my honest opinion, I do think the original House of Wolves Trials gear looks the best. Just straight up black and gold. Looks insane. If you go to one of my old videos, you can definitely find it. I also made a Reddit post. I'll probably put it in the description if you guys want to check that out. So that's going to be it for this week's Crucible. Is it Tuesday yet? If you like this, let me know on Twitter or in the comments. I can definitely make more of these. Maybe every time Iron Banner comes around, I can make one of these. It'd be pretty neat. So yeah, just let me know what you guys think. If you got anything cool from packages or trials, let me know. And I will catch you guys again next time. Peace.